Oracle integration allows you to create process applications to automate virtually any business process in your organization. There are four main building blocks that can comprise a process application. The first of these is a business process. Every process application will include at least one. In Oracle integration, you can create both structured and dynamic processes, and you can mix and match them in a single process application to take advantage of their relative strengths. Structured processes follow a sequential and predictable path. Business process modeling notation, or BPMN elements, define the flow and behavior of the process. Key elements include human task activities, start and end events, system activities like calls and notifications, and several types of gateways that allow you to specify different paths of execution that a process can take. A dynamic process is very different from a structured process. It's a collection of activities or tasks without a predetermined sequence of execution. Those activities and tasks can be organized into stages that can happen in parallel or sequentially. These activities and stages can depend on conditions with other activities or on the context of the process payload. These processes allow for changing circumstances during process execution, and they typically require expert knowledge on the part of the users. For most processes, you'll create and edit human tasks to model user interaction with the application during runtime. You can model different types of interactions. Users can submit information. They can review, approve, or reject requests or orders, or perform some other custom action. Manual, non-decision-making, and repetitive tasks can even be automated. A robotic process automation adapter can perform these tasks automatically and leave more complex tasks for human action. Web forms define the interface that your application users see during runtime. You can create forms from the ground up, or you can base them on an existing data structure. You can add controls to a form and configure its data. You can also define the behavior of a form, like dynamically showing or hiding certain form controls based on data or the state of other controls. Your forms can also show information that's retrieved from other systems using their APIs. You can use presentations to allow web forms to be rendered differently on different devices or to present different sets of data to different users. In Oracle integration, you can create and activate integrations and then use these integrations in your process applications to communicate with other applications or information systems. At its simplest, an integration encapsulates the logic to interact with one or more back-end systems. A large collection of adapters enables connectivity with both Oracle and non-Oracle SaaS and on-premise applications. The fourth building block in process applications is the decision model. Decision models are used to automate policies, computations, and decision logic. To create a decision model, you first add and order decisions. Decisions are containers for logical notations like Boolean expressions, if-then rules, and decision tables. Decision tables are the notation of choice to model complex logic. The tabular layout helps you effectively document all the possible conditions and results of a decision. After you've created the decisions for your decision model, you define their input data and type, model their logic, and test them. Finally, to use your decision model in one or more process applications, you expose it as a decision service. A decision service specifies the decision and the input and output data you want to expose and makes that decision available as a RESTful service to communicate with process or other REST client applications. Process applications, via its implemented business processes, can help organizations streamline their digital workforce and allow people, systems, and robots to cooperate and deliver better and faster business results. Learn more at cloud.oracle.com.